Hey guys, welcome back. In this video we've got a brand new soldering iron, so it's all ready to go, but the plug is wrong, so in this video we're going to put on a 13 amp square pin plug. So this, for a lot of people, might be a very basic video, and for other people that have never done any wiring, this video will definitely help you. So we have our soldering iron here, and we're going to just turn it around, and we're going to look here. Before you buy any soldering iron, just make sure it has 220 volts or 230 volts or 240 volts. That is for Europe. If you have 110, that is for America. So the 220 is obviously the lowest voltage, 240 is the highest voltage, and 230 is the average voltage in between the two of them. It makes no difference whatsoever which one you have. It just basically just means that they pick the average, the highest, or the lowest voltage, just to be in comparison. If you are in America, you'll use 110 volts. Okay, anyway, this is the right one for Europe and for Ireland, but this plug here is definitely wrong. It came with a European plug. So what are we going to do? We're going to chop off literally the plug off it. We have our 13 amp square pin plug here, and we're going to join it on instead. So then when we go to the wall and the socket, we can just plug in this plug straight away. We don't need any funny adapters or do anything strange. So the tools I'll be using is a wire strippers. Not important, but I just like using it. You can just use an ordinary snips, as long as the blade just here is sharp. And obviously then our two plugs ready to go. So first things first is we're going to cut the end of the plug off. I'm not going to use this plug again, so I'm just going to cut it quite short. If you do use them again, you can give them a bit more length, but I'm just going to give it kind of make it short. And personally, I like using the wire strippers and cutters on the snips. So we're going to just chop it there now. Gone. Cut. Discard it. Gone. Okay, next thing. Maybe give us some lint. That might help. Right. Okay, we're just going to strip off some wire now. No, we'll give it that much more. Maybe back there. Okay. Now, you'll see that there is two colours. If you can see them there, maybe that's a bit better. So, there's two colours. There's brown and there's blue. So, which one is live and which one is neutral? That's the big question. Well, put it to you like this, and this is the way I've learned it, and this is the way I've seen other people explain it, and it's the most funniest way to remember it, and you'll never forget it. If you were to touch a live wire, which colour would you shit your pants? So, obviously the live is going to be brown, and blue, which is calming, is going to be the neutral. So next job is we have our screwdriver, which I probably should have had. So on display. So just going to open that now. So inside here, the top is going to be earth. Unfortunately, this one doesn't have an earth inside it. So the earth is going to be actually obsolete. This one here on the side is neutral, so that's going to be the blue one. And the one with the fuse is going to be your live. So the way it's going to work is, it's going to come into this plug here, which is the live in, which is here. It's going to travel through the fuse. It's going to come down as this plug just here, and then into the brown wire, and all the way down to your soldering iron, goes through the circuit and comes back up in the blue, up to here, to your neutral terminal, and then into the neutral prong just here, and then into the wall again. So obviously it's a circuit, so it has to do a full loop. That's why you'd have the two wires. We're just not going to use the earth, so that's actually just not important at the moment. So we're going to wire these two up. So put them underneath the little bracket just there. Pull them through. We're going to splice off the brown and the blue. Maybe I should give him a bit more than that. That's, gosh, that's awful thin wire. Because the wire is so unmercifully thin, what we're going to do is actually loop it up back on itself, just to give us a little bit more volume to the wire. Maybe some people say that's not the right thing to do, but because the wire is literally so thin, it's the only thing I can do, because it'll just be damaged and pulled through. So we're going to go with the neutral first. So you see that neutral is going in. It actually does have to bend back on itself. And we're going to keep that. And there we can keep a little bit of extra length to the neutral. And oops. So maybe I should explain this first of all. So this is the plug here, and when it's all wired up, obviously I haven't wired up just yet, but we're going to keep the live, which is the brown wire, a little bit shorter than the neutral wire. The reason for it is, if you were to tug on it or pull on it, the first thing to break is the live wire. So that means now everything has been isolated, so only the neutral is still connected. So that's why you put a decent loop here on the neutral, but keep the live very short. And it's a very clever design. The only thing that's bad about this design is when the plug is on like that, when you drop it down, it always lands prongs up. And late at night, if you're walking around the house and there's kids' toys or whatever, or something, or the Christmas tree lights have been unplugged, you'll always stand on them. Guaranteed. It's a bit like when you drop your toast, it always lands butter side down. So that's the only downside to these plugs. They're actually very clever, and obviously then you put a bit of a loop here for the earth, so the earth and the neutral will always try to stay in the plug, where the live will be pulled out first. Okay, so let's wire this up this time. Actually, that's the thing about this plug here. Obviously there's no earth on it, and both cables are equal length, so obviously when you pull them out, hopefully it would isolate. But the problem is, if it comes out at an angle like that, so you can see that it didn't come out quite out, there is a chance of touching one of the wires, or having it, if you dropped a screwdriver, you're testing it. So this is actually a better design, and also you'll see, if I hold it like that, the earth is actually a longer one than these two here. So obviously if you were to put in the plug only halfway, the earth is in. So it is protected by the earthing circuit, but these won't touch. And when you're pulling it back out, the first thing to be disconnected is actually the live and the neutral, and the earth is always the last thing to be disconnected. So I actually think it is actually a far superior and very intelligent design. The only downside, of course, is you'll always stand on the plug. Right, now let's actually try and get this wired up. Okay, so these wires are so thin. Okay, I didn't record it, but it wasn't very interesting. So basically, just push the wire into the neutral, tighten it down, push the wire into the live terminal, push it down. This is a clamp here that holds everything nice and tight. Tighten the two screws down here. So now the cable is held in nice and tight. The blue one is in the blue side. The brown one is in the brown side. Right, get the lid on next. We don't have an earth because that's the way the soldering iron is. Just came without an earth. Okay, that's it. Now all connected. So it's a very small little cable. Unfortunately, that's just the way it is. Now, first things, if you are putting a brand new plug on, I've already taken it off, but is there a little paper element just here, and it'll tell you what each color is and where it should go. Do not keep it on here. Pull it off, take a picture on your phone, throw it away, put it off for safety, and put it anywhere but on the plug. The reason I'm saying that is, when you plug it in and these plugs get hot, this thing is all in plastic, and it's plastic designed not to catch fire or not to melt easily. And if you use a paper element or a little piece of paper that's just here that tells you the different colors and where the wires go, you're basically leaving a ignition source there. So take it away. If you really want to take a picture of it, but throw them away. Never leave them on the plugs. Okay, so now that's it, basically done. So there's the plug and the soldering iron, and of course it works because it's the exact same setup. So we don't need this. Okay, done. So guys, thanks very much for watching. Don't forget to rate, comment and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.